YouTube are set to release 3 brand new analytics to help you analyse and grow your channel. These could be absolute game changers. Let's take a look. Hello everyone, my name is Rob. Welcome back to vidIQ, the YouTube tool and service that aims to help you get more views in less time. And let's kick this video off with a question. If you could have any YouTube metric in the world to help you grow your channel, what would it be? Let us know in the comments below. Now, YouTube offers up lots of analytical options at your disposal. You've got watch time, subs driven, audience retention, traffic sources, the list is almost endless. I say almost because YouTube is about to add 3 more to their arsenal. If you're a regular follower of the Creator Insider YouTube channel, you will have noticed recently a big video on 3 new analytics they're about to add. And if you haven't watched the video, it's definitely worth checking out. But I'm going to paraphrase it all here right now. Okay, metric number 1, impressions. To understand what this means, we have to work backwards. First of all, we have YouTube watch time, the physical number of minutes you watch a video. Of course, to watch that video, you have to actually click on the video thumbnail or title, and that's counted as a view. But how many times was that video served to a potential audience? And this is where impressions comes into play. Impressions is all about potential audience reach. Take this as a basic example. You have a video with 1,000 views. That's all well and good, but how many times did YouTube serve this video up to an audience? Let's say in this particular example, you have 10,000 impressions on this 1,000 view video. That means that you had a click-through rate of 10%, and we'll get onto click-through rate in a bit more detail later. But let's say, for example, this video was served up 100,000 times to those 1,000 views. That would be a click-through rate of just 1%, a big difference of course. So impressions by itself shows you how much YouTube is serving your video to a potential audience, and hopefully that should debunk any myths about whether videos are more searchable and discoverable when monetization is on or off. You should also be able to check your traffic sources to see where your views are coming from with those impressions, so whether or not it's been served upon suggested videos, search, that's all going to be very useful data for the future. For example, if you're a how-to or tutorial channel, you would hope that most of your impressions appear on the search pages on YouTube and potentially suggested videos on related content. Alternatively, if you're a vlogger or you're covering a very niche area of YouTube, or indeed you are the star of a show, then you would hope you've built up a core audience of super mega rabid fans who are coming to your content from the subscription pages where there are impressions to be had. As a video creator, you can influence the number of impressions served by YouTube, but ultimately it's down to their algorithm, which of course you and everybody else has no control over. If impressions represents reach, then a click-through rate represents success, and that's where you do have some direct control. Essentially, click-through rate is a percentage of impressions. So if you have 100 impressions, 5 people click on that video, that's 5% click-through rate. And that's where 2 crucial elements of any video come into play: thumbnails and titles, to entice a viewer to click on that video and get that click-through rate. Now, this does raise an interesting point. Now that we know what click-through rate is that going to encourage people to produce more clickbaity videos just to get people into the video? Well, listen to this.
Creators really should think about both the click-through rate and the average view duration together. The click-through rate tells them how well their thumbnails and titles convert potential viewers into viewers. Mm-hmm. And the average view duration tells them how engaging their content is and whether viewers are delighted by the kind of content they're uploading.
This makes obvious common sense. If you want viewers to click on your videos, you want them to stay there as long as possible in order to grow your audience and your channel. But there still might be people out there who just want to get viewers into their videos for ads maybe, and to monetize their content. Well, listen to this extra, really interesting piece of information.
If someone has a really high click-through rate, but really short view duration, they're not likely to get a lot of promotion from YouTube. Is that fair?
That's fair to say.
So in the back end, YouTube's algorithm is churning through those numbers, comparing your click-through rate versus your audience retention. If those don't match up, it's going to affect your impressions, which means your videos will not be served as much as another one with a high click-through rate and high audience retention. Bear that in mind when you're creating your content. On the flip side, if your video is performing well, both in terms of high audience retention and high click-through rate, YouTube then may decide to increase the overall impressions for your video. In turn, because that's reaching a much wider audience, many of whom may not be interested in watching your video, that could lower the click-through rate, but at the same time, it's been served to so many more people that you should have a lot more views. So don't just trust the click-through rate as a pure percentage value. The third and final new YouTube metric is unique visitors. Let's say you have a video with 10,000 views. Does that actually represent 10,000 different people watching your video? Not necessarily. There could be 8,000 unique views and 2,000 duplicate views from people watching your video again and again. Why might this happen? Well, let's say you have a fantastic tutorial that's 20 minutes long and people want to refer back to it over and over again. That could be one reason why somebody watches a video more than once. From a channel-wide perspective, it will also give you an indication of how many videos a unique viewer watches. It could be that one person watches 5 of your videos, and then you can determine whether or not your unique viewers are converting into subscribers. Definitely interesting analytics, well worth checking out once they're available. All of which brings us to two important questions. When will these analytics be available and where can we find them? As usual, YouTube is being a bit vague on the official release date. They'll probably just appear in your analytics at some point in the near future. As for where they are, well, they showed us a screenshot that looks like this. This comes from the Creator Studio Beta Edition. If you don't know where that is, check your Creator Studio and there may be a box in the bottom left-hand corner. As of now, here at vidIQ, we don't have any of those options yet, but we'll keep checking it, and when they are available, we'll certainly let you know on social media. And so I open the floor to you. Are you excited by impressions, click-through rate, and unique visitors? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. And of course, here at vidIQ, we're very interested in these new metrics, and who knows, you may be seeing them in our tools very soon. Stay tuned for that. If this is your first time here at vidIQ, we are the service and tool that aims to help you get more views in less time. Our tool is free to download, a link is in the description, and while you're at it, click on our subscription button and notification bell to make sure you don't miss any more of our content. Enjoy the rest of your video making day. Bye for now.